Parashat Korach. Korach was actually a villain. He stood up against Aaron HaKohen and Moshe Rabbeinu. It's fascinating, however, that the Kotzker Rebbe calls him a tzaddik. He calls Korach the Heilige Zayde, the Holy Grandfather. If you know a little bit about Kotzk, however, you'll understand that he meant it with a strong degree of cynicism. How could he have even connected Korach, who rebelled against Moshe and Aaron? How could he even have thought that he was the Holy Grandfather? Listen to Korach's words, his argument to achieve greatness. He dares Moshe and Aaron to continue their leadership. He suggests there's no reason why they should be leaders and he not. Kol ha'edah, he says, the entire congregation, kulam kedoshim uvetocham Hashem. Everyone is holy and God is in their midst. After all, every single Jew and Jewess was present at Har Sinai, heard God's voice directly and received the Torah. Kulam kedoshim. Madua titnasu al kal Hashem. Why do you, Moshe and Aaron, hold yourselves above the rest of the congregation? We are all holy. The Heilige Zayde. What was wrong with his logic? And what was wrong was very important. If you think back to Parashat Kedoshim, a very important commandment in the Torah, Kulam Kedoshim. That's not what the Torah says. Everyone is holy. That's what Korach said. Kedoshim tihiyu, you shall become holy. That is what the Torah commands. God created human beings with a Yetzer Tov and a Yetzer Ra, with a good part and a not so good part. To a very great extent, life is a test. The world is not a perfect world. Our job is the taken olam b'malchut shakai, to make the world better and more perfect. Not to sit back and say, we're created in God's image, and we're all holy, and we all have greatness. It's not by accident that Korach is bald. Because a bald head can't grow any more hairs. And growth, individual growth, never to be satisfied with what you've achieved, but to go higher. That is the goal of Torah and mitzvot. And that was precisely how God proved to the rest of the people the specialness of the tribe of Levi, of Moshe and Aaron. He has representatives of each tribe, bringing a staff, fire, and incense. Fire in the fire pans and incense. What was the message? The message is that everyone is the head of a shevet, of a tribe. But everyone is not necessarily equal. Fire is the source of human creativity. We change substances by means of fire. We take an edible food and make it edible. With incense, we can make a stale environment a much more pleasant environment. With incense and with fire, we create, we grow, we develop. The staff of the tribe of Levi developed flowers like a tree. That's the symbol of growth. Not of Kedoshim Atem, but Kedoshim to you. We must be God's partners in making the world better and making ourselves better. Korach did not understand the challenge. He said Kulam Kedoshim, but he was not really a Heilige Zayde. He didn't grow. Shabbat Shalom.